In this video, we'll examine the ethics of collecting dinosaurs, or what I'll call good dinosaur paleontologists versus bad dinosaur paleontologists. This is the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger, and in this video, we'll discuss the differences between good and bad scientific practices in the collection and curation of dinosaurs. So I belong to a nonprofit organization called the Society of Vertebrate Paleontology, which has a code of ethics that its members abide by. This code has five parts. First, professional standards in collection of fossils. It's the responsibility of vertebrate paleontologists to strive to ensure that vertebrate fossils are collected in a professional manner, which includes the detailed recording of pertinent contextual data, such as geographic, stratigraphic, sedimentological, and taphonomic information. Adherence to regulations and property rights. It is the responsibility of vertebrate paleontologists to assist governmental agencies in the development of management policies and regulations pertinent to the collection of vertebrate fossils, and shall comply with those policies and regulations during and after collection. The necessary permits on all land administered by federal, state, and local governments, whether domestic or foreign, must be attained from the appropriate agencies before fossil vertebrates are collected. Collecting fossils on private lands must be done only with the landowner's consent. Fossil preparation. Fossil vertebrate specimens, such as dinosaurs, should be prepared by or under the supervision of trained personnel. Publication and education. Information about vertebrate fossils and their accompanying data should be disseminated expeditiously to both the scientific community and the interested general public. Commercial sale or trade. The barter, sale, or purchase of scientifically significant vertebrate fossils is not condoned unless it brings them into or keeps them within a public trust. Any other trade or commerce in scientifically significant vertebrate fossils is inconsistent with the foregoing, in that it deprives both the public and professionals of important specimens, which are part of our natural heritage. All right, so let's look at a few cases where dinosaur paleontologists or paleontologists in general did not exactly abide by some of these ethical standards. Our first case is with Dr. John Rennesberger, who is a well-known paleontologist. And in 2002, he and his students were actually caught collecting fossils in the Hanford Reach National Monument in eastern Washington, and they didn't have a permit with them. So his crime was not obtaining permission to collect fossils. Nate Murphy is another well-known dinosaur paleontologist, and in 2007 he became involved in a lawsuit over the ownership of some fossil dinosaur remains that were found on a private ranch in Montana. The landowners argued that he did not disclose the true value of the fossils to them, and they were seeking ownership. Now, in the court proceedings, it was discovered that he was actually finding fossils on federal lands and then faking the locality information as being found on private land so that they could be sold. His crime, faking locality information and trafficking in federal property. One of the biggest problems in dinosaur paleontology is poaching and smuggling dinosaurs out of one country into another country, as well as selling fossils. In all these cases, greed significantly decreases the scientific value of a dinosaur. Now, the uptick of smuggling dinosaur fossils was really kicked off when, in 1997, there was a nearly complete skeleton of Tyrannosaurus rex called Sue that's now in the Field Museum in Chicago. And it was sold for $7.6 million by the Sotheby's auction house. And this is after a very lengthy court case in which the court found that the fossil actually belonged to a Sioux tribal member named Maurice Williams, who was initially paid $5,000 by Peter Lawson at the Black Hills Institute to collect fossils on his land. Now, the auction had a really dramatic impact on the paleontology community. So all of a sudden, overnight, the value of dinosaurs was valued up in the millions, where before they were typically in the hundreds or thousands. And at that time, the United States also did not have strong laws to protect dinosaur bones. So people could collect a dinosaur, and if caught, they would pay a small misdemeanor, a few hundred dollars, and they wouldn't serve any jail time. This is a few years also after the release of the first Jurassic Park movie. And the entire country was sort of dinosaur crazy. Rock and mineral shows became sort of the source of a lot of black market sale of dinosaur fossils in the back rooms. Researchers started to see their sites being vandalized. As smugglers would break in, they would take only the skulls or anything that they saw was valuable, and they would leave the rest of the bones or destroy them, which is awful. So in 2009, the United States passed the first real strong law to protect dinosaurs and other vertebrate fossil remains on public lands. And it also stiffened the penalties of the collection of dinosaurs without permits. Since then, the value of dinosaurs has dropped, and there's been several recent high-profile dinosaurs that have failed to sell at auctions. However, many dinosaur fossils continue to be exported either legally or illegally from the United States to be sold in Europe and Asia. Now, I personally don't have a collection of fossils. I find that museums do a really great job of maintaining and conserving the fossils that I do find, so that they'll last long after I've died. If you have your own fossil collection, I urge you to keep really diligent notes. And consider an institution that would or could serve as the long-term home for your fossils after you pass away. And in this way, you know, the fossils will become important part of a research collection, and then the next generation of scientists will have it available to them. All right, so you now should be able to discriminate between good and poor scientific practices in the collection and curation of dinosaur bones.